had to make a couple of changes to the game. What I found in the last two episodes I recorded this morning was that the volume of the game was just overriding my microphone, so you could hardly hear me at times, and that probably wasn't really good. So I've reduced the volume of the game considerably, so you can still hear bits and pieces, but it is much reduced. Okay, anyway, we're going to head back to Marcia Inc. In the last episodes that I've put to scrap, I have headed back to the DCF system, which is where my engineer is. Because before I get to Sol, I need to make sure I've got my ship upgraded, and from my understanding, my first engineer is going to be at this location. So before I go too far away from here, I need to get my ship upgraded, and the first thing I want to do is to get a faster friendship drive. Okay, so what I'm going to be doing, this is going to be the first episode of the engineer series. Once we finish the engineer series, then we will do the remainder of the trip to Seoul. Over the next week, I will still be working on getting my permits to go to Seoul. So by the time we finish the engineer series, we should be able to head directly to Seoul and visit Earth, Mars, Google, all those. Okay, so we're dropping from orbital cruise. Yeah, I was a bit annoyed. Two episodes an hour long, and when I was listening to them, you could hardly hear my voice, so not too good. Okay. Cutting engines. Need to be within 7 kilometers. Okay, 6 kilometers.
Odyssey Romeo Uniform November. Commencing automated flight control routine. Please observe docking protocols.
Okay,
access granted. Proceed to landing pad 01.
So what I'm doing here is meeting with my engineer, and what she wanted me to do was to bring her a quantity of items, which I provided in the last episode, and once I donated it to her, each of them costing 200,000 credits. I've been basically able to communicate with her, and I can start upgrading my ship.
Landing gear deployed.
Water docking is just so much easier than doing it manually. Okay, so we need to go to local services. First thing I want to do is do some advanced maintenance. I just want to check if we've got some structural damage. We'll get that fixed. I think I sold all my data, so I'm just going to check. Yep. That's all sold. Okay, so we need to meet our engineer, Felicity Foster. This is her station. Okay, good to see you again. Have you seen anything unusual during your voyages among the stars? She's a legendary explorer who offers an extensive training program for technicians and mechanics planning to venture into the black. Developing a relationship with her will result in an introduction to another engineer. So that is important, because if I don't deal with Felicity, I won't be introduced to another engineer. And that probably would not be good. Okay, so I need to upgrade a few things. Now I can upgrade my engines, FSD, power plants, or sensors. I want to do the frame rate drive. Okay, so I've currently got a 4E, so I'm going to select that. Now I can actually have faster boot sequences, increased range, or shielded FSD. I'm not too sure what the shielded does. I think it's to do with thermal load, so it probably prevents, I think it prevents overheating. So what I'm going to do is probably do the increased range. It's probably more important than anything. So it'll give me an increased range. For this I need to get a material called atypical disrupted wake echoes. For that I need to get a wake scanner. Data recorded from a disrupted frameshift wake usually follows a familiar pattern. Sometimes these show abnormalities, which often makes the data more valuable. So I need to go and get a atypical disrupted wake echo, and for that I need to go and get a wake scanner. And we're going to get out of here, and we're going to go to our system map, and for wake shift drive I need to go to, I believe I can get one at, I don't think I saw one here, so I think it's at Garay Terminal, so we'll plot that. Okay, we'll see if we can get our hands on the wake shift drive. Yes, there was a bit of noise that I had to toss away the last two episodes. But I did a fair bit in the last two episodes, did a lot of travelling. Okay, let's get out of here.
Charging.
So as you can see, I've turned down the volume.
3, 2, 1, engage.
Okay, Garay Terminal. Now as you're leaving the atmosphere, you can see with that vertical line here at the bottom, it's showing your distance above the horizon of the planet. So it'll be 25 kilometers above. As that goes, as that line goes up, that's how much further away from the planet we are. I'm just going to go up slightly more. And still being affected by the distance of the planet to us. We're at 200 kilometers and rising. Through the atmosphere. Now we head straight towards Garay Terminal. So everything that I was talking about in the last two episodes, I will go through and mention them again. The first one was how you actually get out of the planet's atmosphere. Reading the actual lines at the bottom of the screen, which basically show you how far away you are from the surface, particularly when you are trying to go to a location that's on the other side of the planet. What you have to do is to, instead of going to another, locking onto another galaxy, what you do is to lock onto, for example, the star in this system. You hit that way, and once you clear of the planet, you then turn around and lock onto wherever you're actually going. Get within 5 kilometers and we should see a no-fly zone at the top, which we have. I'm going to cut power.
Chris Bucking. Delacy, Romeo, Uniform November. This is flight control. Please note that access to the station is by authorization only. Request approved. Set down on landing pad 2-9. Automated docking approved.
Access might be on the other side of the base. Give me a bit of chance to practice docking.
Landing gear deployed.
Okay, so we want to buy and store modules. So we need a put down here somewhere. Wake scanner. I think that's what I need. Calculate the destination of our hyperspace jump by analysis of friendship's energy wake. I can get that one, that's 13,000, or I can get that one for 40. Or get that one, that's 121. Might do this one. Okay, buy module. And that's now stored, so I'll go to stored modules, wake scanner, and find a place to put it. So I'll put that into there. Okay. You can set the fire grip in the right hand cockpit panel. Now I think I've also might have added some other items. So let's just have a look. I'll go to fire grips. Now what I've got are the pulse lasers. And the discovery scanner, so what I need to do is to move down here and I'll make that a 3. I can't make the 3. Oh, okay. Maybe, I don't know how that works. There can be five. I'll turn that off for the time being. Okay, we'll have to go and test it. Okay, so I need to takes it out of here. So let's order launch. Thank you. bit out of range of the base. wait for those lines to come together. Cool, got it. Okay, so what did I get? Anything? Close, I'll drop speed to almost nothing and then start scanning it. Full speed towards him, and he said full speed towards me, then no chance of scanning. Okay, new data discovered. Very typical disrupted way echo. Hopefully that's what I need. Let's see if there's no other contacts. I believe that was all I needed. Okay. Let's head back. Go to the system that is needed. Go across. Go to the planetary map. That's what we want there, fast here. Set it up so that I either have wake scanner or weapons. So if I'm not using the wake scanner, I'll set it up so that those are disabled and the guns are the option. I know you can set up different groups, but I haven't quite worked out how you do that yet. Okay, so head back to the engineer. Trying to decide whether to turn off the orbit lines. That does make it a little more difficult. I might try that for the next episode. I think I remember doing that about four or six episodes ago, four or six years ago, I should say, and found it really difficult. circles there, you have to line up with the dots. That's on the left of the radar screen. And it's possible, but it's quite a bit easier if you've got the screen graphics there as well.
landing gear deployed.
Talk to our engineer. And we want to go to FSD. The one we wanted was that one. Okay, so it's saying here that we picked up atypical disrupted wake, cost is one, we have three. We might do, to quickly check, I'm going to fix this up, install those, those being active. And I'm just going to turn that off for the time being, it will only have it on when we actually need it. Turn the weight scanner back on. So what I need is to check get some storage or infantry. It's not there. Okay, so we got the 1 meter alloy, which will sell for 195,000. A whole bunch of stuff here. Atypical disrupted wake echoes, pattern analysis, wake exceptions, emission data. Inconsistent shield sub analysis. Okay, so too sure what that is, that's all new to me. Okay, so I mean we pretty much have what we needed. Atypical disrupted wake echoes, it's showing 3 of 100. Okay, so go back to our engineer. So we want to get an increased FSD range. Give you further and faster, longer range jumps are allowed with this modification, but at the cost of module integrity, power draw, and higher mass, an explorer needs every advantage they can get after all. Okay, so we'll generate the modification. This will improve the overall performance of your module, however, if any attributes are listed in red, they will have negative effects. Are you sure you wish to proceed? So we've got to fix the power, mass, and integrity. That's what the, okay. What does the experimental one do? The number of experimental effects available, the materials required will vary depending on which effect you choose. Okay, so that's this one here. We would need 5 of them. Galvanizing alloy is better. Yeah, interesting. Okay, so we should have a updated FSD. I can then go to the next rank, which will be requiring chemical processes. I'll need to work out where I actually get that. Okay, Let's go back to our ship. Have a look at outfitting. Make sure it's not a stored module. No, it's not. I think it's already being installed. It's core internal. Okay, so what that's saying is that we've had the modification. If we don't want the modification, then basically we can remove it. But yeah, that's fine. I'm pretty sure we've got the modification to the 4E frameshift drive. Interesting. I wonder, we got any updated messages from the engineer? Maybe not. This one was from earlier on. Okay, so let's do a test. I said I wanted to go to the solar system from here.
Not much further we're taking.
Actually I'll do Alpha because I'll be able to get to Alpha Centauri. Let's see how much further it takes me. Yeah, it took me a little further. I think previously I only got up to Puppus sector, so it's given me a little bit more. So it's like give me to 3/4 of the way to Alpha Centauri. That's pretty good. Okay, so let me just remember what I need. Go back to, I need to just check what I need to get for the FSD. Already got that one. So I need to get chemical processes. Okay, we'll be looking at doing that on the next episode. Craft high grade blueprints. You need enough engineer reputation to have completed all lower grade blueprints at the same time. So I need to have engineer reputation. Where do I see my reputation with the engineer? Go back to here. The more upgrades you commission for me, the more our relationship develops, so I've got to buy more stuff from it. Yep, that makes sense. Power plants, but I need to update that. One shield emitters. I've got anything that I just wanted to see if any of these had anything that I already had. No, I don't. Phosphorus collection plants have kind of surfaces in asteroids. Yeah, I actually like the engineers. It actually brings a new part to the game because with getting the phosphorus, you would have to do mining. Or buy the phosphorus from a market somewhere. What else did we have? Surface scanners, FSD. Let's class one know more about. So if I do class one, mechanical sphere. Look at all of this. This will keep me going for years. Okay, anyway, I'm going to finish the episode here. Obviously, what we need to do is to go to the next modification for the frame-out drive, which is chemical processes. After that, strange wake solutions. We've already got one of these data mined wake exceptions, so yeah. Yep, makes sense. Anyway, I'm going to finish the episode here. If you enjoyed the episode, please leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so, and catch you next time. See you then. Bye-bye.